subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
I have with me Mullapalli Ramachandran, the President of Kerala Pradesh Congress Committee. Thank you so much for joining us, sir. Very few days left for the elections. What are things looking like right now? A lot of people are saying that LDF isn't facing the kind of anti-incumbency that one would expect. Do you think the same LDF-UDF alternate practice that has continued in Kerala for time immemorial will continue, or things will be more difficult for UDF this time?
You're sadly mistaken. I do not know from where you got the information that there is no anti-incumbency factor here. There is anti-incumbency factor. Above all, the people of Kerala are deeply agitated over the misrule of Mr. Pinarayi Vijayan, our left chief minister of Kerala. He ruined the state. The economy is in doldrums. People are worried. And unemployed youth are in agitational mood. They are all frustrated, deeply disappointed. And in months together, they have been conducting the satyagraha and hunger strike, etc., etc., before the Secretariat of Kerala. That's the kind of situation prevailing here. If you look at the life of the ordinary people, be it a fisherman or agriculture, a mass, or for that matter, any section of the society, they are not at all happy about the performance of the government. And what is the hallmark of this government? Corruption. That too, corruption involved in the chief minister and chief minister's office. That too, the secretary of the party and his family are involved. These are the kind of situation prevailing here. So under such circumstances, if you are a voter, will you be voting for that party which is the present dispensation in Kerala? No. That is the feeling of the common man here.
The UDF manifesto that was released a few days ago is in the news again, because it is one of the promises that the manifesto is making is that the Shabrimala, the people who go to Shabrimala, the people who believe in that custom, they will be protected. The legislation will be brought in to protect it. What does it exactly mean? Will it bring in a criminalization also?
May I tell you that manifesto of a political party or a coalition set up as such, that is the manifestation of the promises that they are going to fulfill when they are in power. But if you look at the performance of the left government, they never keep up to their promises. They have never got their promises implemented. That is not the case with Congress or UDF in the past. Whenever we have given promises to the people, we stood by that. Not only we stood by that, we got every single point in the manifesto is implemented in toto. That's a record. And people know that. Here is a section of people, although they are not in power, they are known for their performance. They are known for their commitment and service to the people. This is our excellent record.
Okay. Can you clarify what the Shabrimala promise exactly entails?
Shabrimala issue, when that issue has reached the state of Kerala, you should understand, what was the stand being taken by the CPM? CPM say that they stand for gender equality. Okay, enunciated in the Constitution of India. We don't dispute that. But the stand of Congress is not that. Congress said yes, gender equality, none is against that. Who included such items in the Constitution? No less a party than International Congress. Dr. Ambedkar and great stalwarts who are the architects of the Constitution had the wisdom to include it in the Constitution. You understand that one? So we don't have any dispute about it. But all the same, we have a stand. India is a secular state. Multiplicity of religion, multiplicity of languages, diverse culture. The kind of attitude they keep towards worshipping places, etc., etc. Such a divergent views are existing here. In such a situation, we said that, as Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru has said, he was an agnostic, you all know. He never believed in any particular religion, or he was the last person to go to any worship, one place of worship. That's the kind of attitude he was. Still he is there. If the right of any citizen of this country to go to a place of worship of his, faith, I'll be there. First person to go along with him to protect his interest. This is the attitude of Congress during the time of that Sabarimala issue. Understand? So, on the question of the state, by raising the question of gender equality, you cannot go to a place where you are not expected to go.
If the Congress-led UDF comes to power, will it bring about a certain kind of criminalization for people who try and go in when they aren't allowed as per the rules?
No, see, but the bygone is bygone. We are not telling about that. But we promise the people that whenever we come back to power, we'll see to it that we will bring in a legislation in order to protect the genuine interest of the lakhs of, a true worshipper of that Lord Ayyappa. This is our stand. This is our concerned view. Okay. That will definitely do.
Okay. The one thing that has hit the Congress party in the last couple of months is the fact that the Kerala Congress M, that had been part of the UDF for time immemorial, has split with the party and has gone ahead and joined the LDF. Christian voters make a substantial population of Kerala, of the state of Kerala. How do you think this split and their move towards the LDF will affect the UDF? Do you think the Christian voters will move away with the party?
May I tell you one thing? If you had the occasion to travel along with Mr. Rahul Gandhi, when he was in Kerala during the last 2 days, from Ernakulam, then Alappi, then again he has gone to Kottayam, then he again came back to Ernakulam. I attended each and every single program along with him. You know the kind of enthusiasm, created by that, tour of Mr. Rahul Gandhi? Tremendous. Unheard in the history of Kerala. And you must understand that if you talk about that Christian community as such, the central Travancore, he is the heartland of Christianity as such. Because largest number of Christian population is seen over there, formidable force over there. And you know, must understand, the largest chunk of people, although they belong to different communities and religious faiths, etc., etc., but majority are from the Christian community. The enthusiasm created, the kind of reception that was given to Mr. Rahul Gandhi, it is wonderful, exciting, and unheard in the history of Kerala. That's the kind of situation of those. The question of Mr. Jose K. Mani group leaving our coalition, and also the kind of misunderstanding you presume about the Christian government, that is out of place. They are all with us. People are with us.
Finally, sir, the BJP has been for some time now trying to make inroads in Kerala, unsuccessfully to a large extent. Nemam is the one constituency they won last time. And this time around, they have fielded former Mizoram governor. And it seems to be the one constituency where there is some possibility of a three-pronged fight. And the Congress also has fielded a very heavyweight candidate. What does it look like, the kind of resources that BJP is pulling in the state to try and further its politics? How does the Congress-led UDF try and counter it?
Mr. Amit Shah is in Kerala today. He came here yesterday. I do not know whether he will be here tomorrow also. But whatever it is, he is in Kerala in connection with the campaign. He was former BJP national president also. You must understand, they are trying their level best, they are pumping in money in crores to see that they have a place in Kerala politics. But this time, their presumption about Kerala is going to be a wishful thinking. Unfortunately, last time, it is because of our, I do not know, doings and undoings that BJP has come into office. Because we were not very serious about that constituency, and you know, through which these people are, created some space for them. First time in the history, and that is a blemish on us. This time BJP will not, open the record at all. That's the kind of situation here. And I was telling, for the last 1 year together, that BJP and CPM has struck a deal which has been substantiated by no less a person than Mr. You understand that one, that your organizers, that mouthpiece of RSS, ex-editor, Mr. Balashankar, R. Balashankar. He was a renowned journalist. He was with the Malayala Manorama. I know him for the last 40 years together. He's a committed RSS fan. He said that there's a clear understanding between BJP and CPM in the state of Kerala in order to defeat Congress, as they have done at the national level. Congress Mukt Bharat. They want to see that a Congress Mukt Kerala. This is their slogan, and both of them join together. You should understand that one. It's not a small thing. Today, I have gone to Vattiyurkav constituency where this party office, that Indira Bhavan, is located. Headquarters is located. I've gone over there. One young candidate, Veena Nair, is fighting election. She's only 31 years, highly educated girl. She was also like you. She was in the media for some time. Very excellent girl, accepted by the people. But there, during the time when Mr. Muralidharan fought election, BJP was second party. Means the fight was between BJP and Congress. And Muralidharan won the election with impressive margin. You know what was the margin? 44,000. And immediately after that, when Muralidharan got elected, then there was a by-election here. The vote of BJP has come down to 28,000. Thereby, a left front, that candidate, Mr. Prashant, won the election. My question, simple question is this. 44,000 they secured in the previous election, which has come down to 28,000. Where did this urban vote go? How CPM candidate come out? This is the clandestine understanding which I have been telling to the people of Kerala for the last 1 year together. And this is one constituency where they experimented this understanding. This is what you'll call. You follow? You report it. With facts and figures, I'm telling you. If they can dispute, let them dispute. I will take the challenge.
So seeing BJP and the LDF are hand in glove.
Yes. There is clear understanding. Hands and glove, they are playing hide and seek in order to defeat Congress, which is not possible. People of Kerala are wise. They are secular. They are democratic. They know how the Kerala, state should go, to which direction the state should move in the coming days.
Thank you so much for joining us, sir. This is Fatima Khan reporting for The Print.